they finished their season 15-2. This is the second state title and the second in a row. So coach, if you would, please introduce the guys and then give us a brief opening and then we'll go to questions.
Okay, down in the end we have forward senior captain Connor Appleby. Next to him we have forward senior Jason Butler, number 12. Ryan Belfury, number 7, senior captain, and Jake Spurlock, number 2, senior captain. We felt confident coming into the game that, you know, if we played the way we wanted to play, that we'd create opportunities. To be completely honest, we don't think we really, played as sharp as we're capable of. But we showed some grit, some determination to kind of not be at our best and still find a way to win the game. And so a lot of credit to these guys. All four of these guys have been a part of the varsity team for all 4 years. This is their third state final in 4 years. Without a doubt, the most successful class in school history for our program. And so we're thankful to them for all they've accomplished and the trust that they've put in us over the 4 years.
Can either you guys that were up front there in the goal area on your winning goal, can someone explain what you thought you saw from from your end of it?
Have you scored?
Yeah.
Goalie scored.
Someone sent, or I think it was whoever was on the free kick sent a good ball in. And
we don't know who it was on the free kick.
Ryan Lindsay. He sent a decent ball in. Their team had to make a play on it, and it didn't go their way, and it just tipped back, and I was able to knock it towards the goal.
Okay, so did you actually put it in the goal, or did the goalie?
The goalkeeper.
Kind of mishit it.
I mishit it, and the keeper put it in himself.
That's not bad. Okay, so fair enough.
But we'll take it anyway when it comes.
For the goal,
sure.
Closest to it.
Hey, we'll take a goal anyway it comes.
Yeah, I got you. All right. Spurlock, tell me. I asked them about how frustrating it was for them to not be able to really get in often. Very little.
Right.
You're goalie.
Right.
You're back there on that defense. How hard was it for you guys to contain what they kept throwing at you?
Yeah, well, we saw every couple minutes they'd have a man. They'd always have an extra man come up. So we dropped back. We saw that they just played the long ball. So one of us, me and Whitty, either stepped. One of us stepped, and then the other shifted back behind us. So couldn't get a through ball in. Just clear the ball. So.
They said whenever they got little space, there was always a defender on their back.
Yeah, we went into the game. We knew they were good technically. They're good on the ball. They want to get the ball up to their front line and then get guys running off. So we really wanted to focus on trying to deny that initial pass in, not letting him get number 11 especially, not getting comfortable on the ball up top. Made him have to look down at the ball, made him have to, play a little bit more frantically. He wouldn't be able to pick out, necessarily the best pass or the best option. Make it a little bit harder just to break us down.
I think Jason Butler had your penalty kick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who had the second? Who had the other goal?
Thank you.
We're gonna say. Let's go. Damn.
If your touch was towards Fran, then it's yours.
So, conversely, they were giving you guys a bad time when you're trying to score too, right? They were pretty good defensively, yeah.
I would say usually we have a lot of good opportunities, and I think they held us to pretty minimum. And they were usually we can take on their guys, but they were good, solid one-on-one, and they were able to stop us a couple times. And it got difficult throughout the game, and then the legs were getting tired, which made it even more difficult.
Yeah, about number 5 for them at the center back, he was legit. He was a legit player. Was good on the ball defensively, good tackling, good speed, and then was pretty good at distributing the ball out of the back once he wanted. And he made life difficult for us at a time, to get some of the chances that we're accustomed to be able to create with our, speed and, these guys, their skill on the ball. He did a really good job of limiting their opportunities.
Yeah, you guys can usually run by guys, right?
Throughout most games we come into, we think, team speed is something in our advantage. With their back line, I feel they, and the way they played, they played kind of a stopper sweeper, so he was dropped off a little bit to begin with. But they had the pace to be able to kind of take that away.
Let's credit your back. Can we name your back line, please?
Center backs, Jacob Spurlock and Josh Whitty. And then outside backs on the left, junior Nick Dunstan Mays, and on the outside right, junior Ryan Lindsay.
When you got the penalty kick, was there any doubt who was kicking it?
To be honest, I let them sort that out on the field. You know, we probably know it's going to be one of these three over here between, you know, Apples, Jay, and Bell. But we kind of, they have a good kind of understanding of who's feeling good, who wants it, and, you know, they've all kind of taken them throughout the season, so they sort that out on the field.
He's been on a hot streak. Jay's been on a hot streak.
So you guys take a vote? What are you doing? What are you doing?
He's just Jay's confident with it that I'm going to let him take it.
Like, Jay's been solid on
the steps up. And been stepping up. I just hit in the left spot every time.
Now you'll tell.
Yeah.
Every time.
Tell what the goalie did.
Nah, you know what I mean.
He's the important, yeah.
The goalie.
Yeah, the goalie was pointed to the left side. But that's the spot I go every time, so I just hit it there too. He made a good effort though on the save.
If he didn't hit that with power, it might have gotten saved.
That was too
difficult
high.
Ball to save.
It was too high.
Don't that's good.
Maybe. Okay, score does it, don't matter.
Ryan, what can you say? I mean, like I told you before, I've been watching you since you're a little shorter as a freshman player, but you've been dynamic since you got in here. To get out of here now with two state titles back-to-back.
I mean, this game wasn't my best game, obviously, of the year. And I think last year's win was more special, to be honest, because it was historic for our school. And, I mean, for me, it was my better game. So, yeah, I mean, if it wins, a win. So,
so what do you attribute to not having your best game? Was it their defense, or was it?
I've been fighting through a hip injury throughout the season, so.
Okay.
What can you say about your goalie's performance in
there? Yeah, I think coming into the season, that was, you know, what everyone was waiting to see what we were going to look like there. You know, obviously, Ryan Miller had kind of manned that for the last 4 years, and deserved all the accolades that he got while he was with us. And so Zach Hetrick, who, you know, stepped in, you know, was starter for JV last year. You know, he continued throughout the season, got stronger and stronger and more confident. You know, as these guys, you know, showed that they believed in him and his, you know, ability to make saves when he had to. And, you know, you saw that in the second half with the tip over the bar. You know, he comes through and he makes saves, you know, in big moments. And that's really all you can ask of a keeper, you know, is make the saves you're supposed to make, and hopefully every now and then, you know, pull one out that maybe you shouldn't necessarily get to.
Do you remember how much time was left when you made that save?
I don't.
It was early.
Yeah, it was early. It was earlier in the half. You know, they kind of put us under at the start of the second half. They were kind of coming at us in the first 5 to 10. I think it was probably about 10 minutes in or so.
Okay.
And
you were expecting them after the half to push for them.
Yeah, and you know, unfortunately, we got scored on, you know, something that we knew they were good at. You know, that, you know, when you look back at their results, set pieces and restarts, they're very, very dangerous on. You know, they scored 3 against North Hagerstown that way. They scored their goal in the semifinal off a free kick. A little disappointing as a coach to, you know, have, you know, something that we focused on, you know, break down and, you know, have them find the back of the net. But the guys rallied, you know, and that's, you know, this group has learned over their 4 years, you know, that game's not over till the game's over, and they know they can create, they know they can score goals, and they know they can shut down teams when they need to.
That's all I got. Anybody else have anything?
Any more questions?